Good morning and happy Thursday. My name is Christy McDonald, and we're coming to you live from the parlor of the Grand Hotel in our continuing coverage of the 2012 Mackinac Policy Conference. We hope you're having a good morning so far, and we're awfully glad that you're joining us at myvote.org, or if you're watching us on any of the PBS stations around the state carrying our coverage, or if you're watching us on any other media outlet's website that's carrying our coverage as well. We want to welcome you aboard. It is day three, the last day of the conference. We're going to have a full schedule for you today. The governor is going to be speaking. Also, one of the most popular sessions of the conference every year is the Fab Five. The regional's leaders in southeastern Michigan always talk. And this morning, just to get things started for me very easily, is Craig Folley from WDET. Craig, how are you? Good morning. We've got the paper on the table. We've got
absolutely
some coffee. We're ready to kind of go into day three. So what are you looking forward to? What do you think we can expect?
Well, I want to know what Dave Bing's going to say. He's having a press conference in just a few minutes here, about an hour from now. Mm-hmm. We have no idea really what he's going to talk about, but there's so much speculation out there about who may be running for mayor and who may not be running. A lot of talk up here about that. Well, let's see if he reasserts himself as the mayor of the city of Detroit today.
It's interesting. I spoke to him yesterday and I said, are you going to run again? And he gave me a very lengthy answer about how, you know, it may not be a one-term job. It could be two terms. He's, you know, he wants to finish things and make sure he at least follows through on a lot of things. And I said, okay, well, so are you going to run? Are you going to run again? And he still hedged a little bit. I know he's told some people that he may run. In the papers today, both papers are speculating about who.
Mike Duggan.
Yeah, Mike Duggan. I'm running, and he's up here pressing the flesh. So I think that's got to be a little unsettling for the mayor to be going forward in doing some of the most difficult job, I think, right now in terms of reshaping where the city is heading and with all of this.
Well, think about the pressure that he is getting right now. He's got the real implosion of the county government structure going on around him. The city obviously has huge financial problems that they're dealing with. You've got this new board that is sort of coming together, but the council so far hasn't appointed their members to the board. You've got pressure from the governor's office to get some things done now. In fact, he wants this board to start meeting right now. And in the meantime, you've got everybody saying that maybe somebody else should be running. So like I said, he's got an opportunity today with this Big Five session to again reassert himself as the authority figure in all of this.
Yeah, and we will see. We will definitely see what happens. Hey, I just want to remind you, if you're watching and you're into social media, we would love to hear what you're talking about and what you're thinking about everything that you've seen from the Mackinac Policy Conference over the last 3 days. So find us at MyVote on Facebook. You can find us at MyVote. Follow us on Twitter. Tell us what you like to see. And our social media power is being brought to us by HAP, so we appreciate all of their help there. So I know a lot of people have been talking on social media and watching this. How have you found the conference? Kind of what do you think the takeaway is going to be from this? And I know it's been great 3 days of sessions, but now it's like, okay, when we leave the island, .. what do we take?
I think what you're going to see is that especially the business community, when you don't have a lot of politicians here,
I know,
because
politicians
of this,
is
they're sort of looking at this as if they're going to do what they want to do and not worry as much about the political situation as they have in the past. Just get things done. We don't have time to wait around for these messes to be cleaned up. So if they can find a path to prosperity without, you know, the fixes on the political level, I think that's what they're going to do. I think they're tired of waiting around.
And I think what people have said to me over the last 3 days is finally, after talking about things for a number of years, like, we really ought to do this or let's do this, that finally there's some action being taken. And I think you're really seeing the business leaders stepping forward and saying, look, we're going to plug whatever holes that we need to do to make sure that Detroit is successful.
For a while. And the thing is, there's some momentum. It's not obviously completely shared prosperity at this mm-hmm. point in time. Some places in the city in particular are doing better than others. Some places in the state are doing better than others. But when you have momentum like this, you can't allow the distractions that exist. And distraction is far too much of an understatement about what's going on in the city of Detroit. But you cannot let this drag down the momentum that does exist. We saw that happen last time. We had a spurt in the 1990s. And then, of course, you had a lot of the downturn and everything just stopped. Mm-hmm. And so we had to wait another decade for things to kick up again. They don't want that kind of a lull
Please,
to ever happen again.
Don't let us wait that long. Hey, next week, Transportation Secretary Ray LaHood is coming into town on Monday. So are we finally going to get the green light on the light rail?
Possibly, but we also might get the green light on another project. little mm-hmm. bit further south of that on the river. So there could be some announcement maybe coming on that too. But I think we are going to see some significant funding for the M1 project.
Yeah, and it's been
he wouldn't be coming to town if it was bad news.
Hey, I'm here. And by the way, no, we're not going to do the light rail. Really interesting how the foundations and the businesses have come together and pooled a significant amount of money for that.
Well, it's look at how much private funding there is. I mean, this is unheard of. Who builds a train, who builds a railroad mm-hmm. anymore? That's always been sort of government's job to build infrastructure. The fact that we have to rely on the private sector to build infrastructure is a little unsettling, but it's happening. And if that's what it takes to get it done, I mean, that's what I'm talking about when they say they're not going to wait around for people to take action to get things done. They're just going to do it. And I don't think they have a choice right now. If you want to keep the momentum going, you can't wait for this stuff to get fixed.
A new model for the city of
exactly.
Detroit. All right. Well, we hope you're going to stay with us for our continuing coverage, our live coverage right here from the parlor of the Grand Hotel of the Mackinac Policy Conference. We will be right back.